Dear students, in this lecture we will derive TDS equations and heat capacity equations. We will derive TDS equation, where T is temperature, S is entropy, DS means change in entropy. These two equations will enable us to calculate the change of entropy during various reversible processes in terms of either dV and dT or dP and dT or dV and dP, even in terms of directly measurable quantities such as coefficient of expansion and bulk modulus. Now we will derive first TDS equation. For that we will express entropy in terms of any two variables from pressure, volume, temperature. Entropy is proportional to two variables. They are S is function of V and T, that is S is equal to S of V comma T. If we differentiate that, we will get dS is equal to dou S by dou V at constant temperature T into dV plus dou S by dou T at constant volume into dT. This equation we have got from the function S is equal to S of V comma T and by differentiating it partially. Therefore, if you multiply this equation 1 by temperature T, we have on the left hand side TdS, it is equal to RHS becomes T into dou S by dou V at constant temperature dV plus T into dou S by dou T at constant volume into dT. We know that from Maxwell's equation, dou S by dou V at constant T is equal to dou P by dou T at constant V. We use this relation in the above equation 2. For a constant volume process, that means for a process if you make volume as constant, in that case TdS is equal to dU. dU is change in internal energy. So that this equation becomes T dou S by dou T, that is equal to dou U by dou T at constant volume, which is nothing but CV, that is specific heat at constant volume, that is defined as change in internal energy over a change in temperature, dou U by dou T at constant volume. If you substitute CV for T dou S by dou T at constant V on the second term of the right hand side, and by using Maxwell's relation dou S by dou V into T as dou P by dou T into V, for this first term we will have TdS is equal to T into dou P by dou T at constant volume into dV plus dou S by dou T at constant V into T is written as dou U by dou T at constant volume V, that is CV into dT. TdS is equal to T into dou P by dou T at constant V into dV plus CV dT. This is the first TdS equation. Now we will derive second TdS equation by assuming entropy S as a function of pressure and temperature, that is S is equal to S of P comma T. If we differentiate it partially, we get dS is equal to dou S by dou P at constant temperature T into dP plus dou S by dou T at constant pressure P into dT. Therefore, if we multiply T to the above equation, we get TdS is equal to T into dou S by dou P at constant T into dP plus T into dou S by dou T at constant P into dT. Using Maxwell's relation, dou S by dou P into T is equal to minus of dou V by dou T into P in the above equation for the first term on right hand side. Also, for constant pressure process, that is the process at constant pressure, we have TdS is equal to dH, where H is enthalpy, so that we get T dou S by dou T at constant pressure is equal to dou h by dou t at constant pressure is equal to Cp. Cp is specific heat at constant pressure, which is defined as the dou h by dou t at constant pressure. If you substitute Cp for T dou s by dou t at P on the second term of right hand side and minus dou v by dou t at constant pressure for dou s by dou p at constant T for the first term on RHS, we get Tds is equal to minus T dou v by dou t at constant pressure P into dp plus Cp dt. This is the second Tds equation. In this manner, we can derive Tds equations related to pressure, temperature, as well as volume temperature. Now we will derive heat capacity equations. For that, we have to consider first and second Tds equation, that they are Cp dt minus T dou v by dou t at constant pressure P into dp and Cv dt plus T into dou p by dou t at constant volume into dv. They are equated in this case. Now in this case we are going to solve for dt. For that we need to take Cv dt to the left hand side. Then we will get Cp dt minus Cv dt. If you take dt as common factor, it will become Cp minus Cv. Now send this minus T into dou v by dou t P into dp to the right hand side. On the left hand side we have Cp minus Cv into dt. On the right hand side we have T into dou p by dou t v into dv plus T into dou v by dou t P into dp. If you send Cp minus Cv to the right hand side, it will go to denominator of the right hand side. Therefore, we get dt is equal to T dou p by dou t v into dv divided by Cp minus Cv plus T dou v by dou t into dp divided by Cp minus Cv. We know that T temperature is a function of volume and pressure. We can write T is equal to T of V comma P, that is, it is a function of volume and pressure. If we differentiate it partially, we get dt is equal to dou t by dou v at constant P into dv plus dou t by dou p at constant V into dp. Therefore, if we equate these two relations, since LHS are equal to dt, RHS should be equal to each other. That means first term of this equation, first term of this equation are equal. Second term of this equation, second term of this equation are equal. Therefore, we will get dou t by dou vp at constant pressure P, that is dou t by dou v at constant pressure P is equal to T dou p by dou t at constant volume divided by Cp minus Cv, and dou t by dou p at constant volume V is equal to T dou v by dou t at constant divided by Cp minus Cv. That is, these two are equal, they are shown in this equation. Both of these two equations results in Cp minus Cv is equal to T into dou v by dou t at constant P into dou p by dou t at constant V. And we can write dou p by dou t at constant volume V as minus of dou v by dou t at constant P into dou p by dou v at constant T. By substituting this in the above expression, we will get Cp minus Cv is equal to minus T into dou v by dou t whole square at constant pressure into dou p by dou v at constant temperature. This is the heat capacity equation. Since dou p by dou v at constant temperature is always negative for all known substances, dou v by dou t whole square at constant pressure must be positive. Therefore, Cp minus Cv can never be negative. Cp minus Cv can never be negative, or Cp can never be less than Cv. That is, specific heat at constant pressure is always greater than specific heat at constant volume. As T tends to 0, Cp tends to Cv. At absolute zero, the two heat capacities are equal. That is, if T equal to zero, RHS becomes equal to zero. That is, specific heat at constant pressure is equal to specific heat at constant volume. Therefore, for example, at 4 degrees Celsius, the temperature at which the density of water is a maximum, that is Cp is equal to Cv.